And welcome to Heroic Duel Disasters. My name is PGA Team America, and today's edition is Deck of Lunacy Mage, where we are trying to get as much value out of Deck of Lunacy as possible, which transforms spells in your deck into ones that cost three more, but they keep their original cost. So our deck is 16 spells to guarantee value when we draw a deck of Lunacy. So we have no minions, it is all spells. At some point I just started kind of throwing random spells in there, and we are going with Wormbolt to give us a shot at board presence. So let's go. We will see how it goes. Just quick mention, if you're watching this on YouTube, please be sure you like, subscribe, and comment if you enjoy this type of content, or if you prefer no variety and just all of the highlight runs, basically. Let me know. We're doing a 2-win prediction. Okay, so part of the key for Deck of Lunacy is to have card draw in your hand when you play it. Do I keep the ice barrier? Sure. Like, we basically only have one 1-cost card that we would play on one. So, if you're tossing this away, you're looking for something else. Like, I don't know what you're looking for.
Ooh, bet there's something great inside.
We should have a pretty good matchup against this deck, seeing as we do not trigger... We will only trigger one of the secrets ever. Hopefully that it is not the one secret, though. See, look, already.
Job done.
More secrets. I have no intention of attacking anytime soon.
Job's done.
Okay, maybe I should have had an intention of attacking sometime soon. Holy smokes. Chat? I forgot about this. I could have Equality Mask, but the issue with that, chat, is I forgot.
Job's done.
We don't have that many cards left. He doesn't have a ton of cards either, but I'm not sure how we're gonna survive. I'm gonna have to eat a freezing trap, and I'm gonna have to eat a misdirection.
I'm getting low on cards.
The hope is that that's all we have to eat. I think I have lethal. Oh wait, what? There's no misdirection? We did it! I had more damage. I was playing around misdirection. So that the reason I attacked with the 6 attack treant first was so that it couldn't kill my other mana worm when misdirection hit. So, we are all spells, so we probably go... Does anyone know how Sticky Fingers works with... Does Sticky Fingers work with Deck of Lunacy? Because it... Ronin's does not work with Deck of Lunacy. I can tell you that. And it is super annoying. Because I know Ronin's won't work. So yeah, so if anyone's wondering what it's like to be a streamer, Sticky Fingers should not work, but who knows? Sticky Fingers should work in the comments. So, very useful. As always, chat. So, first science in the heroic duel disaster. And just in case anyone is unaware, if you play Deck of Lunacy twice, it doesn't do anything. It basically just, like, re-randomizes your deck, but, like, it was already random and you didn't know what was in there. So, it essentially did nothing. Does nothing.
I will fight every teacher here if I have to. You look suspicious. I will write you up.
Well, we will find out in 2 turns, chat. Well, Ying, why would we play at turn 2? Why are you waiting? Probably better to wait, but you could not wait. This also helps us against, like, if you were to play South Sea Deckhand or something. It frees up our hero power. Not that that's... Ooh. Okay, so that's half our life. It does make it cheaper, by the way.
Job's done.
Wait, no it doesn't. No it doesn't. It doesn't. It doesn't. No, that's a 5-mana spell. It doesn't work, chat! It's worthless! Well, I mean, it doesn't even work with Ronins. Like, Ronins won't even make it cheaper, which is absurd. Okay, so far this turn, he has made his weapon have +2 attack, played Cutting Class, and a 3-3 with Taunt, and he didn't spend any mana to do it. And then he got a new... spent 1 mana to get a new hand of cards. Our weapons cost 2 less, so that's good.
May I have this dance?
Yeah, all we need is a lay on hands again, like we got last game. Hey, that's cheaper. Yeah, that's us being out of stuff to do. Oh no! He seems confident, chat. That's an eviscerate. Yep. Okay, well, there's some card draw and more spells. Granted, we can't. It's really tough for us to get spell damage. my knee's been hurting, and I was wondering if it was, like, arthritic pain-ish. So I used my dad's arthritis cream, and oh my god, it's supposed to take, like, a few weeks to work, but it worked, like, in hours. It felt so much better. So I don't know if that's a good or a bad thing.
Mozaki versus Fireheart.
I won't go easy on you. I just like imitators. Spells.
Okay, we'll keep the primordial studies. Oh, we're looking for a zero mana guy, probably. But the thing is, because I don't feel the pain anymore, the pain was the only thing keeping me from sitting incorrectly. Oh wait, oh, Blood Mage Thelnos would have been zero mana because of the sticky fingers. I should slow down. So because the sticky fingers did absolutely nothing for us the game before, I kind of forgot about it. That's nice. I didn't want to kill the Grand Totem Eyesore anyway, chat, so... Perfect. Dude, something's gonna be freaking huge. We only need one more piece of Cthulhu. But it's also gonna be harder to, Man, Ring Toss is a lot worse with the sticky fingers now. That doesn't inspire confidence.
I'll write that down.
I don't really have the option to smork. I have to draw Maw of Cthulhu basically now. Aegis mark. He's pretty close to killing me. He's got... way too much damage. I could have killed the Earth Element as well. I'm seeing that now. This won't work, right? Since it's countered, he doesn't get another spell, right? And the train stops. That being said, we are, Yogtastic Tasties? Of course we get Deck of Lunacy. Well, thank you so much, Deck of Lunacy. He has... yeah, we're dead. There is no card that saves us. Killing the big taunt wasn't enough because he has a lava burst in hand. Predictions are going. The run's not over. Okay, we're continuing with more spells. We will just have to mulligan even harder for Deck of Lunacy.
My own way.
Spells be the greatest weapon of all.
We got this awesome treasure, which is fine. Maybe we just, like, oh my god, all our expensive... is it good for our expensive spells to be the ones that we draw? Because our expensive spells are actually pretty good. It's not like we want Doom and stuff. No, Ice Lance is worthless. Oh, he doesn't have C'Thun in his deck. So I can Ice Lance and play Cryomancer. So you want to keep, you don't want to drop them below 27 unless you're, because you don't want him to draw a card when he heals his face unless you're doing significant damage. Well, that's rough, IMG. Getting comboed by 35 plus damage with Gift of the Legion always feels bad. But it happens. So we spent 2 cards and 6 mana to give our Boulder Fist Ogre +1 attack. Sticky Fingers does not work with Deck of Lunacy, we learned this run. I mean, it also doesn't work with Ronins, which is even worse. Well, we achieved our goal of 2 wins with the deck. Oh, that's nice. I like Path to Power a little bit more than more spells. I'll let you guys vote on 4 wins. I do not expect to win another game, so good luck. I don't even think spell damage +3 would save us. It would make the cram sessions absolutely disgusting, though. Spells be the greatest weapon of all. Cram sessions are nice, but we don't have any spell damage to go with it, so, like, mulliganing is basically the same thing. Do I want to wait for a card draw before programming the Deck of Lunacy, or just count that we'll... I don't think I coined the Deck of Lunacy here. I changed my mind. Come on, kill yourself with a trick. Kill yourself! We need to not hit a 1 in 8 though. Hello, Hoots. How are you doing? You've joined us in the middle of a heroic dual disaster run where we are. We started with all spells in our deck. Thank you. We have 18 cards in our deck.
Could you repeat that?
Come on, three. Crap. That's a guarantee kill. You monster. Watch this. I probably should have done Fireball. Because you get Spellburst. So Spellburst is kind of like stealth and the minion has it whenever it's summoned. As long as it's not a copy. Or it's a new copy. I guess that is kind of weird that it says a new copy. Okay, summoning a copy is different from copying a minion. That's what it is. Because, like, Gift of Luminance wouldn't get the spell burst.
Distract me.
I get that fireball on our face, getting ready to go. Ah! It would have been better to. I shouldn't have attacked face, I don't think. So Ultraps, since we don't really play minions. Ultraps? Oh my gosh. Good slug, thanks for following. Glad you enjoy. Yeah, no, it's Caltrops. Man. Ooh. Flame Waker seems decent. I love Primordial Studies. And Magic Trick. Both of those you can discover Deck of Lunacy with, so.
Gotten along with trolls.
I despise paladins like you.
I mean, he called us a troll because he's a racist. That's why we don't like him.
I'll show them. I'll show them all!
The light protects me.
I wonder if he thought it was scattered caltrops.
Job's done.
No, 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 no. Okay. Wait. Oh, the Avenge came after I pinged. Okay, okay, that makes sense.
Try to keep yourselves alive.
If this comes back, I'll be so sad. Oh my god, it comes right back and everything dies again. I'm gonna make him do it. No, it only happens the one time. It doesn't keep repeating.
Come one, come all.
Better be something.
Oh, no.
Did he end his last turn with a ton of mana? Oh no, we draw cards. Oh wait, is that because my hand fills up with spells? That's... okay. Yeah, Yogg-Tastic Tasties doesn't work super well. That didn't go great. So it's funny how now this is getting the cost reduction from Sticky Fingers, but it wasn't before.
Servants, soldiers of the cold dark, obey the call of Kel'Thuzan.
I didn't need it anyway!
Ah, he needs a kiss!
I didn't need it anyway!
Part of the issue is his big minions will have rush, so they're all getting damage.
Don't keep your thoughts to yourself.
That Oh, well, we can mind control whatever it hits. So that'll be our Valinir, right? The only issue is if it hits a stealth minion, then we're in trouble.
Let me work my magic.
Oh my god. I was like, wait, why didn't it show anything? Did I die? Easy clap. Imagine doubting the top deck. Pyroblast. So we probably have to keep our deck thin since we still only have one Lunacy in it. Okay, we are having to take on the worst classes with the worst decks. And we're barely scraping by.
Versus Fireheart.
I won't go easy on you. I just like imitators.
Spells be the greatest weapon of all.
And we, like, all of our wins, basically, we play Lunacy right away. Wasn't it Vin Diesel that said it doesn't matter if you win by an inch or a mile? I thought Paul Walker was the one that was making a big deal about how close he was. we gotta draw Lunacy or Yogg in order to scan. Casual Plague Bringer opponent. I mean, I took a bucket specifically so that I could discover Deck of Lunacy, and then the next game I discovered Deck of Lunacy. So you can't get on me for not trying. That freeze is only on minions. It's almost like when your win condition is one card in your deck, it's not ideal. And that well-balanced decks that don't rely on you drawing one card are the way to go. Come on, 4, 7. That's not 4.
True mastery takes dedication.
And we spin the wheel and we munch on him. Oh, wait, crap. We don't get the minion though, because it's the tasties. That makes me sad. It just destroys him. We're in trouble. The Plaguebringer made this not go well.
Could you repeat that? I'll write that down.
I should have done it on this. Because I only took one damage off instead of taking two damage. I'm basically dead. Was that made by Web Spinner? I don't think that works. Okay, well that's probably not going to be great. He's playing super conservatively, isn't he? Fuck. He has an Alakir in those cards. Once I traded, I should have played Alakir. I know when I guess. Holy shit, that was dangerous. Once I knew he had an Alakir in his deck, I don't know exactly what that last play was, but that was dangerous. That was definitely dangerous. Because I had made the decision of the play slightly beforehand, and then I didn't react when I saw it. I didn't think about the fact that it was from his deck. Yeah, I was about to get value from the Nazoth and Twisting Nether. I wanted to make them useful. That I was so focused on getting value from them. From Jewel of Nazoth in a deck with no Death Rattle minions. Is this just Hyper Blaster? By the way, 5 wins. 5 wins. Like, this lets our treasure not get Lunaseed. But yeah, also, thank you everyone so much for hanging out today. I super appreciate it. If you enjoy, please be sure to hit the follow button. Also, I upload runs every day on YouTube with this queue time edited out. Also, my good deck lists are in Discord. I don't have a meme deck list channel. And you can get updates on Twitter. I haven't actually posted on Twitter for a while. Also, Droder, I looked on my Steam profile, and for some reason, you wrote a really nice message on it, and I didn't understand it. Also, I don't remember you ever watching me when I only had single-digit viewers. This was on my Steam profile. Someone wrote a comment, and I'm pretty sure it was you. It was you, right? Yeah. I assumed it was a copypasta, because it was something nice to say. You don't understand. I had single-digit viewers for, like, 6 months streaming.
You look suspicious. I will write you up.
And it is difficult. I started streaming in September, and it wasn't until I got number one, the month after I got number one on the leaderboard, that I got up to like 40 viewers, and it was super exciting. Hello, Pam. I'm seeing less and less of you recently. Which is sad.
I'm almost out of time. You here for the tour?
Those frost bolts might be nice. I can play an imprisoned phoenix. Yeah, I don't have as much faith as you, Misty Warus. I don't know if... I was like, I'll get two turns to get ready for the Phoenix. It also scares him. Like, he ain't putting anything on the board. Probably until this Phoenix is gone. But, I mean, I have four cram sessions. Maybe I needed to wait. Okay, well, definitely freezing his face now. The freezes on his face help keep us alive a lot longer. Because it's like... Yeah, because of how the self-sharpening blade works. Also, super exciting gameplay from him.
I'm almost out of time.
This is mostly intentional, I'm pretty sure. It's always worked like that. Oh, you're talking someone asked about Death Strider. Yeah. Death Strider always crashes with Tonkin Python, like LCS said. I thought he was talking about the screen. Usually it reconnects you to the game. So if the game ends from the tonk, you won't be able to reconnect, and it'll just be a win or a loss.
It's not a competition. I'm too good. I'm almost out of time.
our time, scrub.
Yeah, beat it.
He's gonna start hitting us, chat. Oh shit. Oh shit, chat. He was holding on to that for so long. I can clear the board, but he just has another one. You can't get Flame Ward. You know that. Also, I would die if I played Flame Ward. Flame Ward would increase the amount of damage he can do on the turn. Yeah, it's basically tasties or bust or dead. Anyways, we did good with this abomination. So thank you, LCS, for sponsoring the run. You're on YouTube, make sure you like, subscribe, comment, let me know what you think of the Heroic Duels Disaster Lunacy Spell Run. Make sure you ring the bell. Thank you for the 5,000 bits.
Legit run here's a down payment on the next disaster run, just need to come up with something worse.
Alright, sounds good, LCS, and thanks for watching, everyone.